The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
You need the runes to fight Dillion.
You need Dillion.
He's waiting for you.
He always said he would wait.
He's close.
He cares about you.
You can feel he's close.
Open the gate.
She can't.
Open the gate.
It's locked. Try harder.
She can't. The gate.
She can't. She will.
She'll find it. She will.
Through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe.
Dillion.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through the door
before he disappears.
Dillion, don't lose him.
You've let him slip away too many times.
You always let him disappear.
Dillion, there he is.
Quick.
You broke him.
You killed him.
I couldn't see the darkness within you. She should have listened to her father.
Why didn't she listen to her father?
She thought she could defy him.
Everything gets broken in the end.
You killed him with your love because he believed in you. your curse has claimed Dillion.
Poor Dillion. He didn't know he was coming out of the darkness.
Nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to everything she loves.
She destroys the thing she loves. You are guilty.
The curse cannot be
undone. Was it worth it? You kill the things you love with your curse. You kill the things that are most precious to you. Cannot be undone. Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one. He's in the other one. He's in the dark world.
The dark.
Thank you.
Dillian cared for her like no one else has.
Dillian's the only reason she's still alive.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young."
"Do you remember meeting him in the tree?"
"Oh dear."
We spend our lives searching for the meaning in life, and we ask the gods for guidance. But the truth to life is revealed when we can face death without fear. How can the gods understand us if they refuse to die themselves? We spend our lives searching for the meaning in life, and we ask the gods for guidance. But the truth to life is revealed when we can face death without fear. How can the gods understand us if they refuse to die themselves?
He's the reason she keeps fighting. He's the reason she keeps fighting.
You can't go up there.
You can't go up there.
Not in this world.
No. Not in this world. You can't.
You've come this far, but the bridge is broken. There's no way you can fix it.
What do you do now, Senna?
she thought she had light within her. She is pure darkness. You have no chance for love now.
Nobody will love you again.
Ever. Ever again.
You can't.
She remembers him. He's the reason she's alive at all. Yours to be alive and Dillian's dead. Doesn't deserve to be dead.
How does that make you feel?
He led you astray.
You should have listened to your father when you had the chance.
Why didn't you listen to him?
This love has tortured you,
and it tortures them.
Your love because he believed in you. Your curse has claimed Dillian.
Poor Dillian. He didn't know he was kind.
He led you
astray. You should have listened to your father when you were young. His love has tortured you.
You are guilty. You will always be guilty.
Was it worth it?
Dillian saved her.
You owe your life to Dillian.
You owe everything to him. Do you remember what it was to touch him?
He was the only one she could trust.
Could she trust him? Dillian saved you from them. He didn't believe that she was cursed.
He saved you when everyone else turned their backs.
You've got it.
Why isn't he here?
He's gone.
He's in the dark world.
He's gone to the dark world.
You're in the wrong world.
He's in the other world.
The dark world.
Without you.
Yours still alive and Dillian's dead. Doesn't deserve to be dead.
How does that make you feel?
There he is.
Where are you taking him?
He's up there.
How do you get up there?
There's a way. There is a way up there.
Find the way.
She can do it. You're nearly there.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Balder. The blind god, Hoth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoth says, "I cannot see where Balder stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon." Loki replies, "Here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands." And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Balder. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Balder is killed. And for this, Hoth is slain.
She thought she had light within her when she has only.
She is pure darkness.
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Balder. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins.
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes. Movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past. And Dillian.
Nobody will love her now.
Her future.
Look what happens to the thing, Charles.
Two realities tearing at her soul.
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur, weep him out of Hel. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they found in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
Do you remember how he made you feel?
no chance of love.
Nobody will love you again.
Ever again.
He saw who she could be.
He saw who she really was.
He saw the warrior within.
Do you even remember?
His love is guiding you.
What if they're all about wasting your time, just delaying you minute by minute by minute? What does she think she's doing? You're not special. She thinks she can.
They mean nothing.
Being special.
Waste of time.
It could all be a waste of her time.
What if the gods are just
playing the soul that she was strong?
What if the gods are laughing at her?
Messing with her.
It wouldn't be this easy.
It wouldn't be the first time.
The sound of his voice.
Led you astray.
You should have listened to your father when you had the chance.
Why didn't you listen to him?
His love has tortured you, and it tortures Dillian.
The Northmen tell how the gods punished Loki for Baldur's death. They captured him and took him to a cave. They fetched his two sons and turned one into a wolf, and he ripped his brother apart. The gods used Loki's own son's entrails to tie him down, and turned these bonds to iron, and dangled a poisonous serpent over his face so that its venom would drip onto him. Each time the venom drips onto Loki's face, he writhes in agony. The Northmen say that is the cause of earthquakes. A reminder, perhaps, that if even gods must accept death, then so must we.
In the tower.
He's there.
Is pointless.
What are you doing?
The way he touched you.
Why did you think you could make this work?
You keep seeing runes. You see runes everywhere.
Everywhere.
But what if they're not real?
What if they don't actually make sense?
The gods were lying. If you think it makes sense, but really the gods are playing with you.
It makes sense in your mind, but it doesn't make sense.
Worlds. Zimbel was right.
You're wasting time.
You're cursed. You
succeed.
So, quicker.
Why didn't she listen to you?
thought she could defy her.
Because he believed in you.
Dillian!
Be very, very careful.
Dillian never much cared for the underworld and looked dimly upon the druids like her father, Zinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms.
No, she's not.
Glad to see the world through his eyes. Slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Be quick. Be quick. Be careful. Don't look down.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have? The gift that makes you so special in my eyes. Just another part of the person I know.
I left for the wilds to protect you from my darkness. Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong?
What if this is nothing to do with the soul?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick. It's just a pointless test.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know.
It's just their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
Say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Where am I?
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others, the voices, they've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet, so dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I can't go on. Dillian?
Find a way. I'm not leaving you here.
I think I'm somewhere else now. The breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Good.
Reach the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Jenny. My friend. He taught me. Not the soul. You can't do that in your warrior trials. This is just the impact. You can beat it.
This isn't for it. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need people like you.
Okay. I'll do my best. a waterfall. I can't go on.
It's not really you.
Then look for another way
and tell me what you find.
It seems there's no escaping the past in this place. And so she's forced to relive it. To what end?
I don't know what's inside.
Don't be afraid.
Not following me.
Leave it behind. Keep moving forward.
Not following.
Leave it behind and keep moving forward.
Thank you. think I'm in a house. It stinks. Of death.
The darkness is testing you. But you are in control.
As well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Tilly, please help me. Please
come to me, Sam.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere. With no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
Were yours, but they're the gods now.